Rowing has been in every single competition since Paris, since the 1900s. It needs power, it needs passion, it needs trainer Brendan McCathy to tell us, what does it take for a rower to win gold?
The entire body strength. Allegedly, this is the most physically demanding activity of any sport. All right, we're gonna do 30 jumping squats on off the silver disc.
Why do rowers need that?
Because when you're pushing in the boat, the first push comes from the glute. What you're gonna do is you're gonna come down, do a press up. There you go.
Rowing seems like one of the most easy sports, but when you do it well,
it's the most beautiful to watch.
It's one of the most beautiful. Football is big around the world. Here during the Olympics, it's going to happen in 6 different locations around the UK, but there are lots of other team sports going on, things like basketball and volleyball. Brendan McCathy, my trainer here, is going to tell us what muscle groups the teams need.
All right, well, let's just get started and I'll explain it while you go. But first thing you're going to do is you're going to sprint as fast as you can. You're gonna go side to side, and what this is doing is it's engaging one of the weakest muscles in the body for most people, which is the inner thigh.
And so the key thing, if you're watching any of the team sports during the Olympics, for the athletes is, Brendan?
For team sports, you need to strengthen the inner leg in order to support dynamic movement.
Athletics is divided into 4 areas. You've got track, field, combined, which is track and field, things like the decathlon, and also road events. So today we're going to do a little bit of working out, and Brendan McCathy, who is with Be Bad, Look Good, is going to give me a little bit of a hard time, but show us which of the muscle groups actually athletes have to work out.
You're using your arms, your biceps, even your back muscles, which people don't realize, shoulders, legs.
Okay, great. What's next?
All right, let's go to the stairs. All right, you're going to run up and down the stairs 3 times as fast as you can. Keep your shoulders up. So there you go. Very nice. I'm going to go and do an exercise people doing high jump are going to do.
Okay, great. That's it. Let's go.
All right.
You think boxing, you think Muhammad Ali, who's going to be here, by the way, during the London Olympics. It's mostly been a man's sport, but this year's games, for the very first time, are going to have women jabbing and crossing. Trainer Brendan McCathy will tell us what muscles boxers need.
Boxers, again, like most athletes, use their entire body, but today we're going to focus on upper body strength. All right, let's just go jabbing across. We're going to do 32, 3, 4, 5. We're gonna do 20 dips to strengthen the triceps. Beautiful
Thank you.
Job, beautiful
Boxing
job.
Boxing has been in the Olympics since the 7th century BC, and it's gonna be here for London 2012.